What's up, my friends? Mr. Gallows, of course. And yes, I feel it necessary to reintroduce myself. Sorry I've been a little bit scarce. You know, normally I like to do maybe about 2 vlogs a week, or I try to do at least 2 vlogs a week, but sometimes it just doesn't work out like that, usually because I'm really busy. And, you know, as of late, I've just been working on a lot of books. A lot of you guys know that I'm a writer. I just finished up my grandmother's memoirs, and then right after I finished up her memoirs, I just started working on a bunch of other books because I want to get them published on Amazon. I'm doing the whole publishing thing on Kindle right now. I'm working on my fantasy story and a bunch of other projects that I want to kind of keep under wraps until I release them, but I will be announcing them soon, and I hope you guys will head over to Kindle when the time comes and support the books, because, you know, it's great material. I'm really, really excited about all the material that I'm putting out. But anyway, I'm going to be talking about that in a later video, all of my books specifically. But today, I was thinking about a topic that I was, you know, I think I heard about this, what sparked this whole discussion here, was I heard about Horton Plaza about a month ago in a YouTube video that I was watching, and it was shocking, because I don't know if you guys know this, but Horton Plaza is a dead mall. Horton Plaza. And I mean, I myself was watching the video, like, you know, he's talking about Horton Plaza, right? Horton Plaza in San Diego. Yeah, guys, it's a dead mall. A dead mall. And I was just so taken aback by this. I mean, because I used to live out in San Diego for a while, you know, I went to the Navy, I was in the Navy out in San Diego. Horton Plaza was my stomping ground, man. Like, that's an old school stomping ground for me. And Horton Plaza was always so crowded with people. I remember how busy that mall was, the food court, and everything, really every corner of the mall was so active and so busy. And now you have people on YouTube who are filming on the weekend, like on like a Saturday afternoon, and it's dead. There's nobody in there. There are no people around, because it's one of these many dying malls across America where, you know, online shopping is taking over everything. So once there's nothing to buy, people just kind of disappear, right? The stores start to disappear, so people start to disappear. Man, there's a lesson right there in society and humanity. There's a big lesson right there. Once there's no shopping, people disappear. And you know, it's really crazy to think about just face value, but really, the most shocking thing to me was that, you know, just Horton Plaza itself being deserted, just the mall itself, because, you know, you hear this guy, this video that I was watching, he was talking about the creator of Horton Plaza and how he actually designed Horton Plaza to be like an amusement park for people to see and to walk through. You know, Horton Plaza has just got brilliant architecture. If you guys have never seen it, I'm sure most of you have, but if you guys have never seen it, you know, look up some videos on Horton Plaza. The architecture in this mall is unlike anything you've ever seen before. There are, you know, staircases and elevators and strange spots, weird spires and, you know, rectangular square and triangular architecture with checkerboard designs, stairways that lead into places you can't see. So you have to go to a certain section and actually cross a bridge, this like pedestrian bridge, into another section just to see where the stairway above leads it, because it's like a puzzle piece. It's like a giant puzzle that's spread out, and all throughout are these stores, are these places for stores. It is literally, quite literally, a playground for pedestrians. You're meant to walk around and explore the mall. There are meant to be places in the mall where you can't see the end to, or you can't see where you're going once you get into it, or you see some section of the mall and you're like, I wonder how I get up there. Well, you can't see it. You actually have to go explore. You have to go across these weird walkways and up these escalators that are completely out of place, and across these rooftop staircases, and then down the other side and across into another hallway. It's like this whole mecca, like for the eyes. It's like eye candy and exploration candy, adventure candy, kind of, for you. You know, you as a person. And that's what the designer of Horton Plaza had in mind. That was his whole goal. And it was only, the shopping was a secondary experience. The shopping was something to do while you were there to keep you entertained, right? And what's so strange to me is why would somebody let Horton Plaza die? I mean, you know, when you think about it practically, San Diego is filled with billionaires, filled with millionaires and billionaires, and they're all just sitting there and letting Horton Plaza die. Why? Well, because all of these businesses are now pulling out, right? And of course, we know online shopping is taking over. That's no mystery, right? So why would anyone want to invest in Horton Plaza? Well, guys, you're looking at it wrong, okay? What you need to do is you need to take Horton Plaza and reimagine it. I mean, think about it. There are so many spaces in Horton Plaza that can be utilized. You can bring, I mean, just off the top of my head, just thinking about, you know, things that could come in there, you could invite, you know, bars to come in there. Bars could open up in Horton Plaza. Beer fountains, you know, wine tasting, cheese tasting. Imagine what, like a bar or like a wine tasting exposition could do with the architecture in Horton Plaza, how they could set up all their events and stuff. You can invite local theater groups to come in. You could set up a theater. If the movie theater isn't in operation anymore, that's fine. Don't rip it down. Turn it into a theater and invite local artists to come in. Same thing with the kiosks in the middle of the floor. Invite local artists to come in. They sell their jewelry. They sell their paintings, right? And then all throughout, you know, the second, the third floor, the fourth floor, all of these places where stores used to be, right? What you do is you create local places. You create hookah bars and, you know, regular bars. You create you can have themed bars like Lord of the Rings bars. You can have, just taking influence from Japan, right? When you walk down the street in Japan, in Tokyo, and through all these big meccas, these big city meccas like Japan and like Tokyo, every single corner is utilized. There's something going on. There's like a little tiny hole-in-the-wall bar, or there's like a karaoke bar. There's themed restaurants. There's people that dress up in cosplay. They do like maid bars and stuff like that, right? Invite those ideas into Horton Plaza. You know, Horton Plaza is not just another dying mall. Horton Plaza is a giant art piece. And even to imagine that this mall that used to be my old stomping ground is dead now is beyond me. Just because people aren't thinking, you guys aren't thinking of it in the right ways. You know, and then once you invite all of that activity back into the mall, then other businesses that used to sell there, they might come back, right? Yeah, but the point is, you need to reimagine the Horton Plaza, and I'm talking about Horton Plaza specifically because no other mall really looks like that. Horton Plaza is designed for imagination. It's designed to have people come in. I mean, think about, you know, walking through Horton Plaza after all of, you know, what I just mentioned there is imagined. You come up the staircase and there's lights, you know, everywhere, neon lights everywhere. There's a hookah bar over here and a great, you know, a beer fountain up the corner, a great themed bar over here. There are street performers in the streets doing juggling acts and eating fire. There's people walking around in cosplay, right? And then you can go into shops and buy things, local art, local paintings. You can go, you know, up to the fourth floor, find your way, right, up to the maze through all of the people up to the fourth floor, and you can go see a show, a local show, a local theater production being put on by a local company. You can literally turn Horton Plaza into this giant artistic mecca filled with, you know, just like I said, filled with cosplayers and street performers and artists, but also you have businesses like bars, right, and small restaurants, small hole-in-the-wall restaurants. You can even invite other restaurant locations to open up in some of these bigger stores, you know, like Nordstrom and like JCPenney and like all these huge stores that used to be there. Turn them into restaurants. Invite other restaurants locations to come back into Horton Plaza, right, once you've created that activity. But what I'm saying is that the locals can fix Horton Plaza. All you have to do is we have to find an investor for Horton Plaza, like a multimillionaire that's looking for something to do, right? Dude, invest all your money in Horton Plaza, right? Come on, people, wake up. Wake up, billionaire. Wake up, billionaires. Wake up. You know, invest all of your money in Horton Plaza. And what you do is you invite locals, the local people, the locals who run their businesses, and you invite them to open up all of these creative, imaginative businesses inside Horton Plaza. come in here with imagination, right? Come, just like I said before, like Japan in Tokyo, you know, themed bars and restaurants, you know, karaoke bars and all this, you know, all kinds of local activity. And what that will do is that will revamp Horton Plaza. And then once Horton Plaza is revamped, then the bigger businesses come back in, and then Horton Plaza is just like it used to be. You know, so it's all very simple. I really think people are not looking at it like I'm looking at it. They're looking at it like, oh my goodness, you know, Horton Plaza is just like all these other dying malls across, you know, America. No, it's not. It's not. It can be saved. This mall can be saved. It's not the same as other malls. This mall can be saved. And I really think we need to do it. It's a really, really important thing to do, you know, not just because we would be saving Horton Plaza, but because you're inviting all of that local talent in. And that's the future. The future is local talent. It's local farms and local art, right? That's the future. And that really can drive, I really believe that could sustain Horton Plaza long enough until some of those bigger businesses come in. You just gotta think about it differently, guys. You gotta reimagine Horton Plaza. Turn it into a giant celebration, a constant celebration. You know, there are places like this all over the place. You know, I've been to Hawaii and overseas and like Singapore and stuff like that, where you walk down the street and there's just, you know, festivals. And you know, these, you know, everybody knows what I'm talking about. Everybody knows street festivals, right? Street festivals come through cities all the time, right? That's what I'm talking about. Turn Horton Plaza into a street festival. Have food vendors, right? Invite food trucks to come in and set up small locations inside. Have a giant tent community, right? That's what I'm saying. Food and art and music and street performers, cosplayers, themed bars, you know, all of this theater, hookah bars, all of this stuff going on. You could have this massive pavilion, and Horton Plaza is the perfect place for it. It's completely set up. It's completely set up to house that kind of activity. So, millionaires, let's go. You know what I'm saying? Invest in Horton Plaza, guys. You know, I got ideas. You know, let's move forward with this. Come at me. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, guys, it's about time for me to head out to work for the day. So let me know what you guys think about that, about, you know, dying malls across America, and Horton Plaza in particular, because I really think there are other ways, right? There are other ways that we can utilize these malls. Don't tear them down. It costs money to tear them down and rebuild them. Leave them there, right? Leave them there, but reimagine them, right? You can do that with every single mall across America, right? Horton Plaza may be the most artistic mall, right? But it's not the only artistic mall in America, right? It's not the only one. So you can do this with malls all across America, and think about how much money that would bring in. Right? How much money and local support as well. So something to think about for today, guys. And of course, leave all of your thoughts and opinions down below in the Great White Void. And I'll see you guys back here for the next vlog very soon. Later.